was in a car accident that put me in a coma for about a week and a half, and I suffered a traumatic brain injury. Wow. And I was hospitalized for a month doing a bunch of different rehabs. And it was just so interesting being in the hospital and just having to do therapies where I had to walk down the stairs. And I just remember glimpses of my memory, like, okay, I was just running down the stairs in high school. You know, I was a junior in high school, and it was just a big culture shock, or like a big change to my world. So it was a huge trip, you know, having my friends come into the room and making jokes, and I couldn't laugh. Like, I could not respond. It was just like this stoic
wow.
type of me. And so I guess, you know, afterwards, because I looked just so fine, and my insurance wasn't the greatest, I didn't receive physical treatment. So there was no physical therapy, there was no massage or any type of physical treatment. So I just really walked around with trauma. And sure, I had speech therapy, but it didn't treat everything else. On top of that, I also didn't see a psychologist for any talk therapy.
Wow.
And so it was like years later, when I was a senior in college, I found myself so anxious. And I almost put myself on a medical leave in college, and I wasn't going to graduate. I was like, I can't do this anymore. You know, I don't know what's going on. And finally, the doctor was like, well, you need to see a psychologist. So I started seeing a therapist at CSUN, thank God. And I learned that all this stuff wasn't gone. You know, I thought, okay, what's gone is in the past. You know, I come from a Latino family that's like tough love, and you kind of get over it in a sense. There's no emotion that you talk about. Yeah, I started seeing a therapist, and that was for years. You know, went and saw a therapist, talk therapy, but again, body wasn't involved. So there was no somatic involvement. You know, it was just talk therapy, and it was more like, I guess, logical thinking through, and, you know, different ways of managing anxiety. But it wasn't until I actually changed careers from behavior therapy to me discovering what it is I was gonna do. I was working as a logistics clerk in a warehouse, and I was just so anxious. I was waking up at like 3-4 in the morning, like, what is my life gonna be like now that I'm not going to have this career that I went to college for, and all of that, you know? All of this unknown. And that was when I was like, you know what, I can just start yoga. I could start practicing yoga early mornings and see how that works out. Yeah, so I feel like it was really the catalyst to me jumping into this realm of really self-improvement and a really big lifestyle shift. I stopped drinking. Mm-hmm. I stopped eating foods that weren't nourishing to my body. You know, I started focusing more on vegetables and clean eating. Started noticing these shifts once I made those changes, you know, sensitivity-wise and what it brought up. But I feel like these big pain factors that we have in our lives can either, you know, push us to be completely something transformative, or kind of we can get stuck in these wounds. Mm-hmm. And I knew there was so much more outside of these wounds than you know, I didn't want them anymore, and I don't want them anymore, you know? I don't want to hold on to them. And I know we can, as, you know, our ways of being, you know, as humans, we hold on to that pain.
Yeah.
Guys,
absolutely.
I knew so much about all of the modalities because I was going through them, and I was literally going from one to the other. Like, I had morning appointments filled with different practitioners, and I was like, you know what? I love yoga, I love crystals, and I love Reiki. you know, like, I think because my mind also works a different way, you know, I'm not so great with like logistical things and remembering all those little fine details, but like, I know healing, you know, like that's all me. And I live through it and I'm still moving through it. You know, I believe that we're always continually healing. Mm-hmm. It was just me realizing like, okay, I either step into this role or I keep trying to find, because it was connected very much with like my career, and everything seemed to fall apart. Every job that I took was just, it didn't work, it didn't stick. And it was almost like the universe was telling me like, you gotta do bigger, you know, like you are far more of what you think you are. You're just playing really small, Tanya. And that freaked me out, you know, but that was really it. It was me just having that trust and knowing that what I went through is what I give back.
Yeah.
You're lighter. You feel like you can actually take deep breaths. You know, you don't feel so small. I know that we can get really tense and tight, and you feel looser. Mm-hmm. You just inside, internally, you feel a shift. And I would say that you feel a smooth flow even, you know, like through your body. It's beneficial because it helps to, you know, it helps with sleep. It helps for de-stressing, relaxation. It helps for any physical or emotional ailments that we go through. It helps to realign and rebalance our chakra system, so our energy system. And it helps too for us to connect to something higher than us, you know? So our spirituality, maybe it's a little dormant. It will kind of spark it and let you know that there's something more that's out there. That's really wanting you to be better and feel better.